We'd like to welcome our next speaker, who's no stranger to the car world. He ignites a lot of good vibes. So, ladies and gentlemen, we'd like to welcome Brandon Maary. Magician, TV producer.
So she gon' call her friends, and that's a plan. I just saw the sushi from Japan. Now you always wanna kick it, Jackie Chan. Dropped up, how we rolling down, don't call it South Beach.
So before I hand over the mic to the man of the moment, not you, this guy. This guy could have been somewhere else today, because there's this huge, I'd say there's a big show happening. But well done. I see you got a lot of love for this amazing couple. So you made the right choice.
Thank you, MC, for the intro. But I got to correct you. The biggest show is here tonight. Not the other one. Cool stuff. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. As you've heard, my name is Brandon Maary. And I'm John from Joburg today. First and foremost, I got to just say congratulations to the newlyweds. Mr. and Mrs. Streamline, you guys look like Bollywood royalty. Round of applause, come on, guys. So it is indeed such an honor to be invited to really the wedding of the season. And I'm sure you all agree that it's been quite a showstopper for day, right?
Yes.
There's so much one can say about Jitesh. And today, I'm going to talk about him as a colleague and as a friend. So Jitesh and I, well, I've known Jitesh now for pretty much 10 years. We started working remotely long before COVID. Jitesh would be our correspondent down in KZN, filming some epic car content, sending it up to Joburg. I mean, you don't need any introduction, you know, Streamline and what kind of content they create for us. But he's been really, really, really great to work with. Shortly after, Jitesh started flying up to Joburg for those day shoots. I'm sure, Jay, you'll remember In and Out. And I mean, this guy would be up at 3 a.m. to catch a flight at 5. I'll fetch him in Joburg at 6 o'clock. We're on the track at 7:30. Filming the whole day, and then in true Amazing Race style, racing to the airport to catch his flight back to Durban. You know, during these days, these really tough days of filming, I was able to see the true Jitesh. You know, people often think making TV is a glamorous job, and it's easy. Well, it's not. It's really hard work, and when you're pushing yourself this much, it can take a toll. Jitesh, however, never once crumbled, nor gave in. No matter how hectic the days were, Jitesh will always make sure the job is done to the best that it can, no matter what the cost is. So Jitesh, thank you for that. So now that your work ethic is out of the way, I can share the other side of Jay. So Jay and I had the privilege of going on many shoots in and around the country and even internationally. And as you can imagine, there's plenty of stories that I can go on about, especially the ones in Vegas. So they're saying
what happens in Vegas stays in Vegas.
Well,
leave it out to you.
Maybe not. No, but I'll keep it PG. So I would like to share a little incident that happened recently in Vegas. Jay, maybe you can help me along the line. So we arrived on day one. It was our leisure day before we could start shooting. And we spent the whole day shopping. And by we, I mean Jitesh.
Gentlemen, especially Sunam, we have just walked into Steve Maiden because your lovely, better second half is about to drop some more money on you.
Vic, where are we? Whose store is this?
We're at the Armani Exchange, which means we're at Jitesh's little G-spot heaven little moment, and he's about to find him a slice at 40% off. So I'm here to help him choose.
Shopping the whole day for you know who?
Sodom.
So we spent literally the whole day, and then we finally got to the last place. It's pretty late at night. And and Jitesh was making multiple trips to the car, back and forth. Shopping bags, back in the store, more bags.
Okay, so let me stop you there. So, you know the whole South Africa scene, everyone so scared of, you know, opening your boot and stuff. So we in Vegas and we know how scary the crime is in South Africa. So I tell Brandon, you know what, when you open this boot, don't open it too high. Because we've got all this Armani, Tommy bags and stuff, and we're like, open it a little bit and let's put the stuff inside. And then we try that.
So I think
open the boot a bit, yeah, put it inside and close the boot.
We try.
Can take over.
So after a long day of shopping, pretty hungry now. So our presenter Vic and I decided to just walk across the road, get some takeouts before we head back to the hotel. So Jitesh decides to stay.
He's learning, Brandon.
I know. That's what happens when you have a bar. And that is why I'm telling the Vegas story. So we walk across the road to grab some takeaway so we can go back to the room. Jitesh stays behind. We get to the restaurant and there's a long line. So we're like, no, let's go back. And we are literally 3 minutes, maybe 5 minutes. We get back. Jitesh is smiling from ear to ear because he found a pharmacy and he got a couple beers there. So anyway, we walk to the car. And there is no car. So I say to Jitesh, please, like, stop playing jokes now. Because in the car was my bag, which had my passport, all the money for the trip, and not forgetting Streamline, all the equipment, and of course the shop. So we press the remote, don't see anything flashing, can't hear the car. Look back at Jay. Jay is like gone, like a ghost. I realize there is no joke. The car's gone. So I run into the store. I'm like, guys, car got stolen. So he's like, no, maybe it got towed away. So we walk back to where the car was parked. And there's a little sign about that big. And it says, customers only or your car will get towed. So long story short, we phone the lady is like, yeah, we just pulled in your car. And we're like, we were a customer. They're like, no, the moment you leave the store, you're no longer a customer. So we're like, cool, how do we get the car back? They're like, yeah, I just got to pay a fine, 7,000 rand. So anyway, we jump into an Uber. The place is closing in 10 minutes. The Uber ride is 10 minutes. So Jitesh tries to come up with a plan. He's like, okay, guys, this is what we do. I went to the pharmacy next door. I've got a receipt. So we'll say we just went next door, you know? So anyway, the Uber driver drops us there. It's the most dodgiest part of Vegas. It was like a scene from a movie. The car dropped us and like sped away. Jitesh goes inside and he starts negotiating. So he walks up to the lady. He's like, ma'am, I don't understand what the problem is. I've got a receipt here. I literally was shopping at the store for 2 hours, walked next door, bought something, and then you towed my car. She's like, yeah, we saw you walk next door, but your friends walked across the road. So we're like, okay, that's not going to work. So Jitesh is like, ma'am, we're from Africa. Do you know what $1 costs? And this money that we're about to pay is our food money for the rest of the week. At that moment, I don't know whether to laugh or cry. But the lady was like, nah, I don't make the rules. Long story short, we paid the fine. Eventually, when we got the car back, just to recap, in the car, my bag, money, passport. Jitesh's camera that we need for the shoot. And of course, all Sonam's shopping. But the first thing Jay did when we got the car was he ran in and looked in every single bag to make sure that all Sonam's shopping was still there. He didn't worry about his equipment or anything else. It was that. And Sonam, if that doesn't say where you place in just Jitesh's life, it's like, you are number one. And, yo, I'm getting emotional now.
Don't cry, please.
I'll try. But, you know, I've seen Jitesh and Sonam together, and I've seen them apart. And when they're apart, Jay's always on the phone with her, no matter what time, early morning, late night, video calling, what. And, Sonam, you found not only the perfect match, but the perfect guy. So please take care of Jay. And you finally got your happy ending, and I'm sure you guys are gonna be living happily ever after. So, congratulations.
I just ordered sushi from Japan. Now you always wanna kick in Jackie Chan. She said she too young, don't want no man. So she gon' call her friends, now that's a plan. I just ordered sushi from Japan. Now you always wanna kick in Jackie Chan.